Hello everyone.
I am Dr. Vankhede, Associate Professor and Head of the CSE Department. Today we will discuss the concrete example on the Bayesian learning algorithm. We have seen that means Bayes algorithm. What are the different probabilities? What are the different components of the Bayes theorem? If we have the required information regarding the means various components, whether it is related to hypothesis, whether it is related to data, and even the probabilities, that is a prior probability, we can calculate the posterior probability by using the Bayes theorem. So we will take the means health related example today to illustrate the Bayes theorem. So this is the example. In this example, the main aim is to predict that whether the patient have cancer or not. All we know is that the scenario when someone is suffering from something, or means if there is any health related issues, generally we visit the hospitals, and depending upon the means status, current status of the patient, generally doctor means suggest some test to give the proper treatment and to diagnose what are the problems. So here this is means one case where the patient takes a lab test and patient takes the lab test and the result come back positive, unfortunately. So now how doctor will verify, how doctor will means use this machine learning techniques, or the hospital will decide, experts will decide in the hospital that the patient have cancer or not. There are two things in the medical practice. One is that the doctor at initial stage will assume something, or we can say that they predict something on the basis of their practice, means how many patients they have treated and given treatment on the various diseases. Say for example, here specially we will concentrate on the cancer specifically. And the second thing is that the lab test results. Again, we know that different machines are set up at the different labs, various labs, we can say that. And as an engineer, we know that whenever any machine is manufactured, or even any component is manufactured, when it comes to prediction, when it comes to accuracy, it is not 100% correct. So in this example, the tests, whatever be the tests we are getting or we are taking through that machine, these are the correct positive with true positive results only 98%. Only 98%. Now you can understand that whatever be the results that pathologist will give on the basis of the result analysis, test analysis done in that particular lab. So in case of the cancer, the 98% patients, 98% patients are, they are have the chances that they will be suffering from the cancer if the machine gives the positive result. The second thing is that that machine, if it gives the result that the test has been done and the patient is negative, he is not suffering from the cancer. So obviously there are two chances: either the test will say that yes, the patient is suffering from the cancer, or else the test will say that the person or that patient is not suffering from the cancer. On the basis of the machine's prediction, it gives the 98% correct result. In case of the positive results. And if that person is suppose did the test and the pathologist on the basis of the machine results conclude that that person is negative, then in that case machines gives the 97% correct results. So if means now there are two chances. If the means laboratory pathologist has given the means report that the patient is suffering from the cancer, then it is 98% correct. And if he says that the person is not suffering from the cancer, it is 97% correct. So this is the means situation. And in real life also means we knows all that whatever be the test we are doing as per the suggestions of the doctors, these are not 100% correct. Even in this pandemic situation, since last 9-10 months, we means peoples are suffering from this situation, bad situation. Even though someone is means suffering from the COVID, doctors also can't say it is 100% or it is means 100% positive or 100% negative. Again, it comes to means these COVID patients, there are two chances that symptomatic, asymptomatic. Why? Because generally means doctors focus on the symptoms, because in many cases doctor will predict on the basis of their intelligence and the means experience. When we give our details to the doctor that I'm suffering from this, I'm having means this difficulty, I'm facing this difficulty, so on the basis of those symptoms doctor will tell us that yes means there are maybe a chances that unfortunately there is some infection in your body and we have to go for this treatment. This is the diagnosis and this treatment is required to cure this disease. So like that, doctor will take decision on the basis of their own experience, and sometimes they will take the assistance from this lab result, because the probability that whether that person is suffering from the means a specific disease or not, for that reason they suggest us to do the lab tests. And one more data present in this example is that out of the total population, out of the टोटल पॉपुलेशंस ओनली 0.008 मीन्स वेरी लेस प्रोबेबिलिटी इज दैट the patients are suffering from the cancer. So this is again one of the important data to predict whether the person is whether the patient is suffering from the cancer or not. This is for the entire population. This is for the entire population. Means, suppose if 100 patients gone through these lab tests, whether they are positive, whether they are negative, the total prediction is that only 0.008 patients, means this is the actual probability, patients are suffering from the cancer, means out of 100 8 only. Means not a 1%, not a 1% patients are suffering from the cancer. Means hardly we can say that if they did the lab test and all, out of 100 population, they are only one patient is the cancer patient. Others maybe means have the somewhat similar symptoms, but it is not sure that they are suffering from the cancer. So this is for the means cancer detection data. In this example we are considering. Now on the basis of this given data, statistically or means on the basis of probabilistic approach, we can say that the probability of having the cancer is 0.008 and the probability of not suffering from the cancer disease is 0.0992 means 99.2%, and when it comes to lab result, this is related to population. When it comes to lab result, the patient for which the lab given the statement that that person or the patient is suffering from the cancer is 98% correct. 98% correct. And when it comes to the नेगेटिव रिजल्ट्स इट इज 97% करेक्ट, 97% करेक्ट। इट मीन्स दैट इफ द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ द पेशेंट who is suffering from the cancer and lab is also suggesting that because of positive result he is suffering from the cancer, but it is 98% correct. Again, there are 2% chances that even though lab has given the positive result, but there are chances, 2% chances at least, that he may be negative. And even though the lab has given the result or report that the patient is negative, but still there are 3% chances, still there are 3% chances that the patient may be positive. Now, on the basis of this data, on the basis of this data, how we will predict, or the how this Bayes theorem will help us to predict and the maximum possibility, we have seen that probability of maximum a posteriori probability. So how this Bayes theorem will help us, how this Bayes theorem will help us to calculate these probabilities. So now we will discuss about choosing the hypothesis. When the new person, a new patient came to the hospital and doctor suggested the test, lab test, and he did the lab test. Now there are two hypotheses. One is that the pathologist will give the report that patient is cancer patient, because if the test will comes positive, and the pathologist will give the report that the patient is not having the cancer because the machine gives the result that negative. Now in these cases, how we will calculate, how we will came to know, how we will predict whether the person, that patient, is suffering from the cancer or he is having the cancer disease or not. So basically in Bayes algorithm, we calculate the this posterior probability. We will calculate this, the posterior probability means probability of the hypothesis in the observed data that we will calculate. And furthermore, we will calculate the maximum a posteriori hypothesis, because most probable hypothesis that we have to calculate. So on the basis of this Bayes' theorem, when we calculate the posterior probability, we want the maximum posteriori hypothesis, and that will be, we will calculate on the basis of this formula. So here, in the many learning scenarios, generally we consider some set of candidates, hypothesis, and we are interested in finding the most probable hypothesis. Suppose we have considered the hypothesis H, and most probability that this hypothesis is mostly probable in the given observed data D. So this maximum, this maximally or maximum probable hypothesis is called the maximum a posterior hypothesis, and it is denoted by this H map. H means the simple hypothesis, but H map is nothing but the maximum a posteriori hypothesis. And we can calculate this maximum posteriori probability of each candidate hypothesis using this formula. Now, probability of the hypothesis in the given data, which is equals to this as per the Bayes' theorem. Now, here we can drop this probability of the observed data, because it is independent. Probability of the observed data is the independent, and it independent of the hypothesis. It is independent of the hypothesis. H. So that's why means it is not dependent on the hypothesis. We can drop this term. So finally, the hypothesis of maximum posteriori that will be equals to the probability of the observed data in presence of the hypothesis and the probability of hypothesis. Again in some cases we can assume the every hypothesis in space H, every hypothesis in space H is equally probable a priori. Here we are means required the prior probabilities also. So equally probable a priori means probability of, say for example, hypothesis 1 equals to maybe probability of hypothesis 2. In general, we can say that probability of hypothesis HI equals to probability of hypothesis HJ, where means all H and J, where all H I and H J are in space H, capital H. So in this way, if this is the case, we can further simplify this equation. If this is the case, we can further simplify this equation as HML. ML is here maximum likelihood hypothesis. We can calculate HML. That will be equals to maximum probability of the observed data with the hypothesis, where here this H belongs to the capital H means space. So in this way, this is means we can say that this is one equation what we have found for the means maximum a posteriori hypothesis, and this is another equation what we have found for the maximum likelihood. So we can apply these equations to calculate the maximum posterior probability and the maximum likelihood. So in this discussion, we will means throughout this Bayesian learning, we will consider the cases. We will consider the cases where H space, where H is the hypothesis space, capital H. It will contain some target functions. It will contain some target functions and the data D. Data D in the training examples. Even sometimes we will consider the cases H the other set, which may be mutually exclusive, and the data D is of other kind of data. So there may be two scenarios. So I hope that means you have understood the Bayes theorem. This is the Bayes theorem, and on the basis of this Bayes theorem, how we have calculated the maximum a posteriori hypothesis, this one, and how we have calculated the means maximum likelihood by using the above Bayes theorem also. So you just go through it and understand how we can calculate the maximum posteriori hypothesis which is required to take the decision or for the prediction purpose.